everyone, and welcome to the Kiki London YouTube channel. My name's Amanda, and in today's video, we're going to be doing this really cute and cozy autumn nail art design. So I really hope you all enjoy watching. To start off with, let's take a look at the colours we're going to be using in today's design. So here we have the gorgeous Coral Whip, which is a really light peachy coral shade. Now for today's video, I wanted to try and include a couple of colours that I wouldn't necessarily use in autumn colours and team them up with more of a few autumn colours and just see how it works. And I was really pleased with how these colours all worked together. But let me know what you think of the colour choices in the comments below. So here we have Feelin Peachy. I do only use a tiny bit of this one. It's such a gorgeous orange though. Then we have a Caramel Swirl. Now this is one you definitely need in your autumn collection. It's such a gorgeous, rich chestnut brown color. It's just really, really beautiful for the autumn season. And then we have one of my all-time favorites, which is Olive Mint. Now, Olive Mint is such a beautiful color, but again, it's not usually one I would reach for too much in the autumn, but I'm really seeing this a lot in recent autumn nails. So I had to go for a color like this and see how it would work with the other colors I chose. Then I did want to have a little bit of sparkle because I love sparkle in the autumn months. So I went for the beautiful Amber Flame, and this is another must have for autumn. It's such a gorgeous glitter. So I'm going to start off by doing my bases. Now I'm just working on display tips today, but if you were doing this set on yourself or a client, you would need to do all of your prep and your base coat first of all before coming in with your color coats. I have got some dedicated prep and natural nail application videos up on the channel, so I'll leave them linked at the bottom of the description box for you guys to check out. But jumping in to applying our first coats of color, I'm just going to come in and apply a thin first coat of color. I did just have a little bit of fluff or something stuck in this nail, so I just used my stripe liner brush to remove that. You want to make sure you remove any little bits that you get in your gel polish before you pop them in to cure. So I've done Olive Mint on the thumb, and then we're coming in with Coral Whip and the pointer and the middle finger. I'm going to skip doing the ring finger for the moment because I'm going to be doing an ombre on that nail. And then on the little finger, I'm coming in with a thin coat of Caramel Swirl. Caramel Swirl on this one is just going to be the background for the glitter. So I'm just popping a thin but even coat down. So now that we've got the first coats of colour down, I'm going to pop these in for a full 30-second cure in my Kiki London lamp. Depending on the lamp you are using, if you're not using the Kiki London lamp, you may have to do a 60-second cure. I would always, though, recommend using the Kiki London lamp because it is the lamp that's been designed and tested for all of the Kiki London products. So it's always best to use the complete system. So now that I've cured that first coat of color, I'm going to come in and apply the second coat of color. So I'm applying the second coat of color, very similar to the first coat, but I do like to apply my first coat super thin. So I apply my second coat ever so slightly thicker. And then as you can see, you've got that gorgeous opaque coverage with the second coat. So I'm applying the second coat on those first three nails. On the little finger, I'm going to come in with that Amber Flame. Now, I love the Amber Flame because it looks slightly different depending on what base you put it over. So here, where I'm putting it over that dark brown, it really pulls those rich gold tones. But if you pop it over a lighter color, it pulls more of an orange tone. So it's such a beautiful glitter to have in your collection. So I popped those in to cure for 30 seconds, and I then decided I wanted to do a second coat of that Amber Flame just to really make those glitters pop and to get a bit more full coverage, because I do like to work in thin coats. And just look how gorgeous this color looks. It's absolutely beautiful. Once again, popping that in to cure, and then we're going to move on to doing our ombre. So on this now, I wanted to ombre the Olive Mint with the Caramel Swirl. Now these two colours I've never ombred before, and I was worried that it could be a little bit tricky because They're very different colors, and also one's quite light and one's quite dark, but I thought I would give it a go. So I'm going to be doing the ombre using my ombre brush. Of course, this makes ombres a hell of a lot easier. So as you can see, I've applied that olive mint, taking it roughly 3/4 of the way down the nail, and then I've added the caramel swirl at the tip of the nail. And then to start off with, I like to just mix those two colors together. So right where those colors meet, that's where I come in first of all and start blending them together. Then I cleaned off my brush, and then I'm coming in to the olive mint, and I'm taking that in to the middle where I've mix those colors together. So I'm not taking it all the way up into the caramel swirl. I'm just taking it in to that new color we've created between the two colors. Then I'm cleaning off my brush, and then I'm doing the same again but with the caramel swirl. So I'm taking that caramel swirl up into the color that we've made in the center rather than taking it all the way up into the olive mint. Always using quite light strokes to go backwards and forwards. The video is sped up, so it does look like I'm working faster than I am. Now, your first coat of ombre is never going to look perfect, and that doesn't matter because it is only the first coat. When you come in and do the second coat, that's where you can focus more on getting the good coverage and the better blend. Now, one thing I did also want to point out is before I pop my ombre into cure, I always give it a minute just to let the gel polish settle and any of the brush strokes to settle out as well. Then I'll pop it into cure. So then we're going to come in and pretty much do exactly the same again. So the olive mint roughly 3/4 of the way down the nail, and then the caramel swirl at the top. And then I repeat that process of blending the center first and then taking the olive mint into the center and then the caramel swirl into the center. Then because it's that second coat and you want it to look as perfect and as blended as possible, I just go over any areas where I feel needs a little bit more blending. For me, I never pay enough attention to the very sidewalls of the nail, so I make sure that I'm going to come in and perfect those as well. As there's been a few ombres I've done and I've noticed I haven't blended the sides as much as the center of the nail, so now I like to make sure I'm really focusing on blending those areas. And then I'm just going over the nail, like I said, any areas where I want to look slightly more blended. You will find that certain colors blend together easier than others. I was pleasantly surprised at how well these two colors blended together because I wasn't expecting them to blend as nicely as what they did. But that is one of the things I do love about the Kiki London polishes, because a lot of them have a creamy consistency, they do blend quite easily together. So I'm just being a bit of a perfectionist here and faffing around just to get this as blended and nice as I can. I'm kind of just making sure that I'm happy with how it is before I end up popping it into cure, because once it's cured, that's it. You can't do anything else to that ombre. So I've popped that into cure. Like I said, I always leave it to settle for a minute, and then we'll pop back to that now further along in the video to top coat. So on to this now, I want to add a little bit of foil. So I've taken the classic metallics box of foils and I'm just cutting off a little bit of this rose gold one. It has a little bit of a satin rather than glossy or chrome effect to it, which I really like for autumn nails. So I've cut a piece of that off, and then of course I'm going to be taking the amazing Kiki London foil gel to apply this. So on this now, I don't want to be covering the entire nail with foil. I just want kind of a bit of a background for some hand-painted nail art. So I've just painted on a swoosh of the foil gel, pop that in to cure for 30 seconds, and then I'm going to take my foil and just tap it along where I've applied that foil gel. I wanted it to be kind of full coverage at the sides and tip of the nail, and then to fade out a little bit into kind of that broken abstract effect, because like I said, I wanted it to be that bit of a background. So I'm focusing first of all on getting on the parts where I want there to be quite full coverage, just pressing over any areas where I want there to be a little bit more coverage, moving my foil around to so that I'm not using the same area over and over again, because obviously you're taking that foil off, you're not going to get any use out of that part of the foil. So this is what it's looking like so far, and I really loved that broken abstract look along the edge. I then decided just come back in with the same foil and just do a little bit more of that, just so it blends out so it doesn't look so much of a harsh line. Then what I'm going to do is I want to seal my foil in before I come in and paint over the top of it. So I'm going to take the Kiki London No Wipe Matte Top Coat and just apply a thin layer of this to the nail. The nail is, this particular nail is not staying matte in the design, but I do personally prefer hand painting over a matte surface. So seeing as I need to seal that foil in, I thought I would go for the matte top coat. Now, one of the reasons I wanted to seal the foil in before I come in and do my hand painting is because if I make any mistakes in my hand painting, I'm then able to wipe it off with some alcohol. Where if you haven't sealed that foil in and you go to wipe off your hand painting, you're going to wipe off the foil as well. So anything you're doing over the top of foils, if you think you're going to make a mistake, it's always best to seal that foil in with a top coat first of all. So moving on to the hand painting, I've taken some of the caramel swirl, popped it down on a palette, and then I've taken my stripe liner brush and I just want to draw on some simple autumnal leaves. I tend to always draw this same style of leaves. I really do need to practice some others, but they're what I find the easiest. So I'm coming in, I've painted down a thin line down the center, and then I'm just going to start painting on these really cute simple leaves. So I start off with a little stem, and then I'm going to draw on the leaf pattern, or the leaf shape, sorry. It's a little bit hard to see it over the foil, but you can see more what I'm doing when I work on the nude side or the coral whip side of the nail. Now, when I'm hand painting, I really take advantage of the 10 second cure on the Kiki London Deluxe lamp. So you'll see there, I've just popped it in for a 10 second cure. And what a 10 second cure does is it flash cures that gel polish in place. So it doesn't fully cure it like what you need to do, but it stops it from running. It's gonna stop it, the gel polish, from smudging. And I find that so important whenever I'm doing anything hand painting, because as you're working up the nail, it's very easy to smudge the areas that you've already painted, or it's very easy as well sometimes, especially if you're not working over a matte surface, for the gel polish to run and bleed a little bit, and by flash curing you completely avoid that. So for example, on this now, every few leaves, I'll just pop it in for that 10 second flash cure. It also helps if you make any mistakes. So if you've done an area of your hand painted nail art that you're really happy with and you flash cure it, then if you make a mistake on the second part, you're able to wipe off the part that you've done wrong basically without removing the part of the design that you're happy with. So that's probably my biggest tip and the thing that I find the most helpful to do when I am doing anything hand painted. So I'm just continuing up that stem, adding on those same leaves. I really liked how this looked with the caramel swirl over both the foil and the coral whip. It kind of broke up the design a little bit, having that foil underneath rather than just having the leaf on a plain coral whip nail or a plain nude nail. Having that little bit of foil underneath just added a little bit of something extra, and it was really quick and easy to do as well. Now that I'm happy with that design, I'm going to pop it in to cure for 30 seconds. And then I did decide to come in and do a second coat. Now this wasn't a necessity, but I just wanted the caramel swirl to pop a little bit more, especially over that foil base. Because we've painted over two different color bases, I thought a second coat of color would just help even it all out and really make it pop. And I'm glad I did just take the time to add that second coat. It's a lot easier when you're doing hand painting to come in and add the second coat anyway, because you have already got your shapes and everything created. So as you can see, I'm just working directly over the top, being really, really careful how I'm applying that gel polish. And the stripe liner brush does make this really easy. I opted to use the stripe liner brush for this design because of doing the stem and the little stems on the leaves, but you could also do this design easily with the detail brush as well. So whichever one of the two you have in the kit, reach for those when you're doing any designs like this. And then of course, once that second coat has been applied, you can just pop this in to cure. Now, and after I finished this design, I kind of thought it would be good if I'd left the base matte and just made the leaves glossy. So that's definitely a design I think I'm going to try next, or soon anyway, because I did like how the leaves looked glossy over that matte base, but I ended up doing the entire nail glossy further along. So moving on to the next nail, this is going to be the thumbnail in the set, and I went for something really simple with this nail. I just wanted to do a cuticle cuff with the caramel swirl. So I have already got some of that down on my palette, and just taking my stripe liner brush, I'm just painting on that cuff shape. This was really easy to do with the stripe liner brush. So I just started from the center and went out one way, and then from the center and out the other way, and then I'm just filling in the gap. And just how cute to these two colors look together. Olive mint is one of my favorite colors, but I'm always unsure what to team it with. So I wanted to try out a few different colors, you know, push yourself out of the comfort zone. So that was why I went for the caramel swirl. And I'm so glad I did, because these two colors make such a cute autumn combination. So there I just took my angled nail art brush and just cleaned up a little mistake I'd made. I was really happy of how crisp and neat this line turned out. So I'm gonna pop that in to cure for 30 seconds. And then on that now, I did only do one coat of the caramel swirl because I felt as though it looked pigmented enough to not need a second coat. So we're gonna move on to the next now. And on this now, it's fairly simple as well. I'm just gonna paint on a cute little pumpkin. I'm pretty sure I'm probably gonna have at least one other pumpkin set up throughout autumn, but I love pumpkins in autumn nails. I just think they look so cute. And I really wanted to add in a hint of that feeling peachy in this set. So on the very tip of the nail, and I love doing this on almond or stiletto nails as well, because you can just add that pumpkin on the very tip of the nail and it just looks really, really cute. So I've painted on a really simple pumpkin shape, pop that into cure, and then I'm going to come in and do a second coat of color because I really want this to pop. So as you can see, it's just two lines meeting to make that bump of the top of the pumpkin, and then I'm just coloring that in. And then I'm going to take my olive mint and I'm going to actually draw on the details with the olive mint. So I'm going to come over the top first of all, just to put a bit of an edge on because it's going to help make that design pop against the coral whip base. And then again, loading up my brush, I'm going to just paint on the lines for the pumpkin shape. So I did these a little bit too straight. I realized after they needed to be a little bit more of a curve. So just bear that in mind if you are painting on any pumpkins. They kind of look a little bit more aesthetically pleasing if you do your lines a little bit more curved compared to what I did my center one there. Once I'm happy with the lines, I'm also going to draw on a little stem at the top here as well. And I quite like it when you do something like a pumpkin and you don't do it in the typical autumn colors. So although we've got the orange base, we've come over the top with the olive mint and it just looks a little bit different, if that makes sense. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. So this is what our design looks like now we've got all of our nail art finished. I was really happy with how well the colors work together. So I decided I would do a combination of matte and glossy top coats. So for the glossy top coats, I'm going to use the no wipe rubber top coat because I like using that over anything hand painted as I find it really smooths out the design. And then on the nails that I want to be matte, of course, I'm going to be using the no wipe matte top coat. So I wanted the ombre and the cuticle cuff now to be matte. So I'm just going to pop a thin coat of the matte top coat over those two nails. And then the remaining nails are going to be that rubber top coat. So again, I'm just going to pop a thin coat over of the rubber top coat. Now, because the rubber top coat is that little bit thicker, I do like to work over it just to make sure I get a nice, even, but thin application. And again, I like this because when you've hand painted on with the gel polish, your hand painted parts of the design are a little bit raised from your base. So by coming over the top with the rubber top coat, really working it into the nail and then letting itself level, you end up with a really smooth surface. So you don't feel any of those bumps from the hand painted design. Once I've finished a top coat in all of these nails, I'm going to pop them in for a 60 second cure, as the rubber top coat does require a 60 second cure. And then this, guys, is the finished result. So let me know what you think in the comments below. I really hope you all enjoyed today's video. If you did, then please do give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, I would love it if you hit that subscription button. Thank you all so much for watching. Lots of love. Take care. Bye-bye.